Between the years of 2010 and 2015, when Syriza was elected, there were many different kind of movements that grew up in Greece. It was the beginning of a new kind of political culture that was based on a grassroots, self-organized structures. Directly after that, it comes the crisis, the deterioration of the conditions, of the labor conditions, of the living standards, of the income of the people. It is, you know, rapid. It was like a shock to the Greek people. By the September of 2012, we had about 200 self-organized groups in education, health, food, without middlemen, time banks, cooperatives, etc., started being existing and built. The change, you know, that was happening in the Greek society was like a huge kind of movement, a huge urgency, and old activists were reactivated, new people, you know, that have never done anything to do with politics, they were seeing hope and they were giving, they wanted somebody in this level of political power to represent them. Syriza was an opportunity for them to kick out the old political establishment, at least. This is what they were hoping for, and to stop the deterioration of their kind of conditions.
The biggest disappointment, and I would say that we suffer as a society, it was the referendum. Mm. It was the first gathering, a syndagma that so many people were down to see the results, and after the results of the referendum, everybody was rushed to Syndagma, and it was the first time after 2012 mm-hmm. that we witnessed that, 2013, 2014. It was kind of, things were like, okay, demonstrations were just passing through the square, a square that was occupied in 2011, 2012. It's packed, Syndagma. And then Tsipras comes to announce, oh, great victory, and you could hear it that he was not pleased with that.
There were blackmails that if, from the side of the Troika, that if you don't accept all the terms of and conditions that we, all the package of the austerity measures, of the bailout, we will kick you out of the euro.
People wanted to react. People came out and voted and no. Not the way they put it, against euro, because if it was another referendum, euro or no euro, the yes would have been high. What people were against, because the way the negotiations were taking place, how they treat the crisis, and how they apply all these austerity measures.
After this victory of 62%, that the people were enthused for the no and the blow and the defiance against all the austerity packages, against the Troika, against the Greek political establishment, etc., the Prime Minister calls a meeting, a joint meeting with the rest of the political parties in order to see how they can reach a new deal with the Troika. And in reality, a few days later, they sign up, they put their signature in an agreement that was worse than the one that the people rejected in the referendum. In the first 2 years of the austerity and the public cuts, we had 35% of the Greek population without countering, you know, the refugees and the undocumented migrants, which then if it adds up to 40%, you know, at least, without any access to the public healthcare system. So this, as you can imagine, you know, in a very short period of time, changed drastically the way people felt about their fate, you know, about their position in this society. This was the big shock that kind of created this force of anger, but then of hope, or looking for hope.
I believe that people do vote, and people are used to vote, and people are used to representative democracy, and that people don't really believe in their own power yet. What happened those years left of revolt and occupations and demonstrations? They gave hope to people. I think they gave them a sense of strength, which found its way to alternative ways of organizing the communities that Christos mentioned, the health centers, cooperatives, the alternative economies, and all sort of collectives that operate right now in all over Greece, and trying through actions of self-organization management to have a sense of power.